Dear students, welcome to Maths for You, your online YouTube channel for 10th standard mathematics. We are covering trigonometric chapter. Let us continue with exercise 8.4. So in 8.4, we are continuing with problem number 5. Prove the following identities where the angles involved are acute angles for which the expressions are defined. That is problem number 1 and problem number 2. So first we will see problem number 2. We take the left hand side and we prove the right hand side. So problem number 1 is cosecant, like left hand side will be cosecant theta minus cot theta the whole square. Now cosecant theta we can write it as 1 by sine, cot theta we can write it as cos by sine. So 1 by sine theta minus cos theta by sine theta the whole square. Now sine theta in the denominator is common. So we take LCM as sine theta, so numerator will become 1 minus cos theta, that is equal to 1 minus cos theta upon sine theta whole square. Now we take the whole square separately for numerator and denominator. So we will get 1 minus cos theta the whole square divided by sine square theta. Now we know that sine square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. So sine square theta can be written as 1 minus cos square theta. So 1 minus cos theta the whole square divided by 1 minus cos square theta. So 1 minus cos square theta is of the form a square minus b square. Then we can write a plus b into a minus b. So 1 minus cos square theta in the denominator can be written as 1 plus cos theta into 1 minus cos theta. So 1 minus cos theta whole square divided by 1 plus cos theta into 1 minus cos theta. Now in the numerator we have 1 minus cos theta twice, denominator we have single time. So we can cancel 1 minus cos theta with the two terms on the numerator. So remainder will get 1 minus cos by 1 plus cos, hence proved. So we can cancel this, so we get 1 minus cos by 1 plus cos, that is equal to RHS. So problem number 2, left hand side will be cos A by 1 plus sin A plus 1 plus sin A by cos A. Now whenever we have two terms on the denominator, that is 1 plus sin theta, here we have one term, no issues. Here we have two terms, so we need to multiply and divide by its conjugate, that is 1 minus sin theta. So numerator and denominator will multiply by 1 minus sin theta. So cos theta into 1 minus sin theta divided by 1 plus sin theta into 1 minus sin theta is equal to 1 plus sin theta by cos theta, and we'll keep it as such. Now 1 plus sin theta into 1 minus sin theta will become 1 minus sin square theta, that is a square minus b square format. So cos theta into 1 minus sin theta divided by 1 square 1 minus sin square theta plus we keep the second term as such, 1 plus sin by cos a. So 1 minus sin square theta become cos square theta. So cos a into 1 minus sin a divided by cos square a is equal to 1 plus sin a by cos a. Now in the numerator we have cos a, denominator we have cos square a, so we can cancel one cos in the denominator, so remaining will have one cos, and denominator both will be cos, so that we take denominator LCM as cos A. So we cancel these two. So we get 1 minus sin A plus 1 plus sin A whole divided by cos A, because here we have cos A second term and the first term also we have cos A in the denominator. Both will get cancelled. So here we have cos A, because one cos A get cancelled. Here also we have cos A. So cos A we take LCM as common. So in the numerator of the first term will be 1 minus sin A. Numerator of the second term will be 1 plus sin a. Now sin a get cancelled, so 1 plus 1 will be 2, 2 by cos a will be 2 secant a, that is right hand side. Hence proved. Problem number 3 of 5. So tan theta by, we'll take left hand side first. Tan theta by 1 minus cot theta plus cot theta by 1 minus tan theta. Now we have to expand the sine and cos, that is we can substitute cos sine by cos for tan, cos by sine for cot. So sine by cos by 1 minus cos by sine plus cos by sine divided by 1 minus sine by cos. Now in the denominator what we can do, we do cross multiply with the sine. So sine minus cos by sine, here cos minus sine by cos. Sine by cos divided by sine minus cos by sine plus cos by sine, cos minus sine by cos. Now sin theta sin square theta divided by, that is the sin theta on the denominator goes on the top, become multiplication. So sin square theta by cos theta we have into sin minus cos. The same way this denominator cos will go and multiply with the numerator first term. So cos square theta divided by sin into cos minus sin. Now this will be sin square theta by cos theta into sin theta minus cos theta minus cos square theta by sin theta into sin theta minus cos theta. Here we have cos theta minus sin theta. I am rearranging it as sin theta minus cos theta. Then I need to take minus out. So I have taken minus out. So minus sin theta become plus sin theta. Cos theta will become minus cos theta. Now the denominators are same. Cos theta into sin theta minus cos theta. Sin theta into sin theta minus cos theta. It is not same because here we have cos and here we have sin. But one term is same. Sin theta minus cos theta. Now LCM will be sin theta minus cos theta, the common term. And which is not common, that is sin theta into cos theta. So denominator will be sin theta cos theta into sin theta minus cos theta is the LCM. So in this we don't have the first term, we don't have sin, so we need to multiply with the sin. Second term we don't have cos, so we need to multiply with cos here. So sin cube minus cos cube divided by sin theta cos theta into sin minus cos. I'll explain this again. We are taking sin theta cos theta, sin minus cos is the LCM. Here we have got cos and sin minus cos, so we don't have sin here, so we need to multiply numerator with sin. So sin square into sin will be sin cube, and in this term we have sin theta and sin minus cos theta, we don't have cos theta, so we need to multiply cos theta with the numerator, become cos cube theta. Now this is of the form a cube minus b cube. A cube minus b cube formula will be a minus b into a square plus ab plus b square. So we are expanding that. So sin cube sin minus cos into sin square theta plus sin theta cos theta plus cos square theta divided by sin theta cos theta into sin theta minus cos theta. Now sin theta minus cos theta the numerator and sin theta minus cos theta the denominator get cancelled. So we have sin square plus cos square will be 1. So 1 plus sin cos by sin cos. We have sin theta cos theta plus 1 by sin theta cos theta. That is sin square plus cos cube become 1. Now we divide separately. So sin theta by cos theta by sin theta cos theta is 1 and plus 1 by sin theta cos theta. That is secant theta cosecant theta. So 1 by sin is secant and 1 by cos is, 1 by sin is cosecant and 1 by cos is secant. So that is equal to 1 plus secant theta cosecant theta. That is RHS. So thank you for watching us. Kindly subscribe, share and comment. Our website is www.maxforyou.com. Thank you.